Hi, Nick from Australian Native Bee here. Today I'm going to go and interview Tom Carter. Tom Carter is one of Australia's pioneering stingless beekeepers. He worked with around the same time as John Klump on the adduction method back in the day, but I thought I would stop by and just ask him a few questions about his hive, how that came about, his experiences with pollination services, and his experience with CADAGHI seed. So I hope you enjoy. And is that one of your normal boxes, or is that a first?
That's my first box.
Yeah, okay.
It's slightly bigger than the ones I use now.
A 20-cent coin box?
Yeah.
So the bank used to store the 20-cent pieces in there?
The bank would get 20-cent pieces in there, store them in there or whatever, and then they would eventually throw the boxes away.
Yeah, wow. Would you say this hive was influenced a bit from the initial one?
Oh, yes. I made it slightly smaller, that's all.
Okay.
As I got used to the different types of bees.
And that's a pretty unique way of doing your roof with the shade cloth across there, isn't it?
Well, that shade cloth just hung over.
Yep.
And the roof clips it on. And that makes 4 degrees difference in the 45 degree heat here in the summer.
Wow, there you go.
Yeah. It still leaves the hive pretty hot though.
Carter built and you got a stencil. Oh, it's very nice. These holes that you put in here, how did that come about? Was that...
I used to put the hole front and back.
Yep.
But then what would happen? The bees would build up here.
Mm-hmm.
They'd come into the front of the hive through there. And they'd build up here.
Mm-hmm.
And come straight up through the hole into the top box, and you'd have brood in both boxes.
Okay.
But maybe only a little bit up in the top, and then they start off in the bottom again. But by putting them up the front, the brood will come up here and to there, and then they'll start underneath again.
Interesting.
And I can mark that and drill the three holes, do the same on the lid, and the same at each end, and they're all symmetrical, so the lid can go.
Wow, yeah, cool. 6 screws. And this is a very interesting entrance hole. How did you come about doing a long one? Is that because that's something you observed in the wild, in the logs, or?
Well, I started off with a couple of boxes used my chisel.
Yep.
Use my chisel to cut out the hole, but now when I buy these, I buy them like this, flat packs.
Yeah, wow. So you got that in there already?
That's cut there.
Wow. Wow, that looks really healthy.
Two hives there.
Okay, so you put them all in a plot. Did that make a difference?
Put them on in fours or fives, depending on the crop.
Okay. So would there be five down the end there, or just five in this
room? I don't know where I had them here and there through the crop. Keep them 30 metres in from the outside, and the bees won't go outside.
Four hives, and that's 1 acre.
1 acre?
Yep.
And then I'll get the crop. Look at the bunches of them here.
Yeah, well, that's incredible.
Well...
Was that Hocking's eye, Siamese eye?
That was Hocking's eye.
Okay.
Damn.
Yep.
And we'll fertilise, one grain of pollen will fertilise one seed. And you'd like to get about 300 seeds fertilised. If you get 150 seeds fertilised, you'll get a melon this big.
Ah.
If you get 300 seeds fertilised, you'll get a melon this big.
Interesting.
Because the seed, that's the big black seeds you see in the melon, they're the fertilised ones. And the seed will, it becomes the reproductive part of the plant, doesn't it?
Yeah.
And as such, it produces hormones. And the hormones make the flesh grow.
Oh. So when you say, what would one bee carry in terms of pollen?
The scientists who study them, they say it'll take about 13 bee visits to produce a nice big 15 kilogram melon.
So, tea tree will abort a fruit flower.
Any other flower.
Yeah, right.
The simple answer is in the Bible. in the first few pages of the Bible, it says when God created all these different things, each one according to its kind.
Yeah, okay.
And you can't mix the kinds.
And that would probably apply from fruit tree too, wouldn't it?
So yeah, exactly.
Banana pollen on, say, apricot or something's not going to be good.
Well, it wouldn't work. You'd fail the board.
Interesting. Wow.
And this was 8 acres with 40 beehives doing the job. Five to the acre.
Okay, wow. And that's the plastic buckets before the metal.
Yeah, exactly. That was the trees over there.
No, I can't really see an avocado on it.
It's got one or two on, that's about it.
So that was, how big was the field in between? 200 metres.
There was about 200 metres of mango tree between them.
Wow, and they didn't go that distance.
And I didn't have the bees out of there here.
Huh.
But they're the same batch of trees.
Amazing. There to there.
No, Simeon, not Simeon anymore.
Yeah.
I think they're Cassio or something, aren't they? And that's
I still
that's the seed of the Torelliana.
I still call them Sarmii. They'll always be Sarmii to me.
And that's what it does to the bird nest.
In your experience, is this bad for hives? I mean, it's...
It'll destroy the hive.
In what way have you seen it?
I think what actually happens, the bees will all leave because the experience I've had with them is that the bees will leave because of the gas buildup in the hive. When you open up a hive and it's like these, it is putrid with a real strong, very strong gassy smell.
Was that a living hive and there's just the bees have evacuated? What's happened?
That's right, that was a living hive.
Wow.
10 weeks earlier that was working real good. And then the seed came. And I would take my bees away from here, because this tree's just up the street. I would take my bees away from here the first week in December and bring them back at the end of January.
To prevent them doing that?
To prevent that, yes.
And would you say that's mainly a tetragonula problem?
See this one here? That's at the front entrance to the hive. That's a seed that they managed to get out, but still miles of it was still inside. And I would clean that away every about 4 times a day.
Okay. How many hives would you say you lost to CADAGHI seed?
I haven't lost a lot because it's taken away.
Yeah.
These hives here were somebody else's.
And what made you take them away? Did you see?
Well, that really, one woman who got a couple of hives off and she had them for a year, and then I happened to be there one day and I had a look at the hives and they were beautiful, working real good. And then 2 weeks later she rings me up and says, Tom, what's happened to the bees? They've all stopped working and there's a horrible smell coming from the hive.
Mm.
And that was what was happening. But see this here?
Yep.
That's the lid. I think, is that a lid? Was it the box?
I think it's the box.
But that's inside the box, see? And compare that in good conditions with that.
Yeah, wow. So that's the aftermath of
Torelliana.
Well, that's quite serious.